And welcome to the Evolve with Emily Show YouTube channel. The best way to support the show on this YouTube channel is to subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and or share it with a friend. I hope that you guys enjoy this episode. In whichever way you choose to support the show, I just wanted to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you guys so much. I hope that today's message and episode brings some bit of positive change to your life. Imagine what our world would be like if everyone loved themselves so much that they weren't threatened by other people's opinions or skin colors or sexual preferences or talents or education, possessions, lack of possessions, religious beliefs or customs, or general tendency to just be whoever the hell they are. Imagine how different your reality would be and the reality of everyone else around you if you woke up every single morning certain of your own lovability and your critically important role on this planet. And if you let go of shame, guilt, self-doubt, self-loathing, and allowed yourself to be, do, and have everything your little heart desired, that's the kind of world that I want to live in. Hey everyone, what's up and welcome to the Evolve with Emily Show. I am your host, Emily Hayden, and in today's episode, I want to share with you 8 ways to love yourself a little bit more. Today's episode is actually coming from one of my favorite books. It's a very entry-level type of personal development book. It's called You Are a Badass by Jen Sincero, How to Stop Doubting Your Greatness and Start Living an Awesome Life. This is a book that I recommend to all of my clients, all my listeners. I've probably recommended it to you guys before, but what I've realized is that not everybody goes and buys the book and actually it takes it in for themselves. So I did this on a previous episode where I shared a few different things from a few different books that I was reading, and I got a lot of positive feedback on it. So I picked out something today from today's book, and I'm going to be reading from chapter 6 and sharing some of the points and just some of how I feel about it in hopes to, one, give you a really good reminder if you've read the book before, because for myself, as I came here to find what I wanted to share, I was like, man, I actually needed to hear this a little bit, and I love it, and it just really inspired me, it motivated me, allowed me to focus on myself a little bit more, and reminded me that it is important to pour into myself in this way, to think about myself in this way, and to be vitally protective over the things that I allow into my mind, and to intentionally place the good things into my mind, and this is a really good thing. So I want to share it with you guys. If you have the book, it's from chapter 6. I'm reading on page 54, and I'm going to be sharing the 8 ways to love yourself a little bit more. The number one thing is to appreciate how special you are. There will never be anyone else in the world that is exactly how you are. You each have special gifts and special talents that make you exactly who you are, and nobody else in the world can ever do what you do the way that you do it. You are the only one who thinks your thoughts. You are the only one who has your perspective and your life experiences. And you have created your own unique reality and are living your life according to your unique path. You are literally the only you that will ever be. You were kind of a big deal. I think that when you realize that and when you empower yourself with that kind of knowing, it allows you to not only, one, hold space for yourself and not compare yourself to anyone else, but two, it actually allows you to hold space for the individual at the other end of the screen, at the other end of the conversation, at the other end of the, you know, wherever you're at. It allows you to hold space for somebody else knowing that you don't have to feel threatened by them. You don't have to compare yourself to them. You don't have to feel insecure about any of their wins or anything that they're doing, because you realize that they're in their own lane and it's non-comparable to your lane, because you are the only you that you can be and they are the only them that they can be. So appreciate how special you are. You can't do that for other people until you actually do that for yourself. So if you do find that you're one of those people that really struggles with insecurities or comparison, or when you get around really beautiful or successful people or people who have something that you may want, if you find yourself feeling uncomfortable around those people rather than inspired by those people, then you're somebody who probably needs to appreciate how special you are. And that's why I really love finding out who people are. When I have the opportunity to meet them or to talk to them, I'm genuinely curious. I'm so curious and I'm so interested. Like, who are you? What makes you tick? What are you passionate about? What hearts lights your heart on fire? What are those things that are about you? Because I know that they're so different from me. We may have some similarities. We may have some similar passions and interests, but I could never be you. I can never think like you. I can never operate like you. I could never do the things that you do. And so it just piques my interest and my curiosity to know what kind of treasure is sitting in front of me. And I think it's because I've recognized that within myself. So appreciate how special you are. The second one, drown yourself in affirmations. Now, the writer of this book, Jen, says, trust me, I wouldn't do this to you unless I had to, but affirmations work. Now, if you haven't read this book and if you haven't listened to the audio version of this book, it really is incredible. And I love her because she's such a just realistic, very blunt, very in your face kind of person. So, and she's also like that. She has a little sarcasm. She's like, I would not tell you the affirmations work if they didn't. So she's like, just get with the program. She says, you don't have to say them in the mirror. You don't have to hug yourself or buy a special rainbow journal with a lock on it to write them down in. But if you want to turn the ship around, you need to rewire your brain and train it to think differently. And this is what affirmations can do for you. Figure out which affirmations you need to hear the most and repeat them all day long in your head, in the car, while you're walking down the street, pretending to be on the phone, under your breath, in line at the DMV. Write it on post-it notes and stick them around the house, on your mirrors, in your fridge, in your car. Write down your favorite affirmations 10 times every morning and 10 times every night before you go to bed and say them out loud. Now, this may seem like a really aggressive approach, but if you're in a spot where your current self-talk is negative, is belittlement, is something that is not productive, something that is not empowering you, not encouraging you, not inspiring you, then you have to take an aggressive approach to change these things. Here's a few examples of affirmations that she shared. I deserve and receive massive amounts of love every moment of every day. I am one with the universe. The universe is awesome, and so am I. My heart is open. Love pours in and out. I receive all the good that life has to offer me. I am brilliant, bright, and beautiful. I love how tall I am, and I love the size of my ass. I told you she's funny. She's great. Guys, custom make these affirmations to you. And if something doesn't work, then come up with something that does work. And you want to come up with something that strikes a nerve inside of you, something that really gets you. And in the beginning, you may feel like it's a lie. Or you may feel like it's, you know, just it feels awkward or uncomfortable or like you're pretending. Guys, if you have to start that way, that's okay. Sometimes it feels that way in the beginning, but you just have to ask yourself, what kind of belief, what kind of mentality, what kind of, what do you want to believe about yourself? Do you want to believe that you suck and you're a loser and you'll never amount to anything and all these negative things that are going on in your head and that you're fat and athletic and incapable? Do you want to believe that? Do you want to continue believing that? Then choose not to continue repeating those things inside of your head. Choose some positive affirmations, even if they don't feel right now. Start getting your mind there, because where you put your mind, that's where you put your focus, and where you put your focus, it grows in your life. You can change your life by first changing your mind. So yeah, it's going to feel weird. It's going to feel awkward, but just give it a shot. And if every single person that is into personal development is telling you that these things work, try it on. You may have to customize it to yourself. You may not be the one with a rainbow journal with a lock on it writing to yourself every single day. You may not be hugging yourself every single day. Maybe you're a sticky note person inside of your car and that does it for you. Maybe you set alarms on your phone throughout the day with these little positive messages and maybe that's what does it for you. Maybe you say it out loud and that works for you. Customize it to yourself, but find something that works and find something that really strikes a chord inside. Don't be fake with it. Don't be ingenuine with it. And don't try to just rattle off whatever you think sounds good. Really customize it to whatever it is that you need to hear. The third thing, this seems simple, but do things you love. How often have you said something like, oh, I love going to the park? And then you're like, man, I haven't been to the park in literally forever, like months. How often have you said, I love seeing live music, but you haven't seen live music in forever? And I know we all just went through a time period where maybe you weren't able to hear live music, or maybe you're right now currently in a situation like that. But how could you get the closest that you could possibly get to it? Are there music artists that you love online that are doing Instagram lives? Are they doing YouTube lives? Are they recording some of their practices? Are they recording an online streaming concert? Is there a YouTube old concert that you could go look up and watch and put it on blast and have a little dance party in your room over FaceTime with a friend? Can you actually attend a live concert? Can you make that happen? Or a live, just live music in general? What are those things that you love? Identify those things and ask yourself, how long has it been since I've done the things on this list? It's crazy. We know what we love. We know what lights our heart on fire, right? But how often are you actually making time for it? And when you realize that when you actually make time for these things, it lights you up. It gives you more life and more energy and more motivation and inspiration to live your life. And you feel refreshed, and it gives your soul that something that it's missing. You always have to ask yourself, what is my soul missing? What does it need more of right now? Maybe you love going to the movies with friends or just seeing a movie with a friend. Can you host a movie night at your house? Could you host a Zoom movie night at your house if that's all that you can do? There are ways to get creative with it, but figure out what are those things that you love and go do more of those things. Number four, find a replacement. Now, this is referring to the things that go on inside of your mind and your head. So you have to ask yourself, what is the current chatter that's inside of my head? And if it's negative, if it's telling you, you know, that you are going to fail at everything, that you're not good enough, that you're not pretty enough, that you're not all these different things, you have to first identify those thoughts. And I refer to them in my Evolve X program as limiting beliefs. You have to find what those limiting beliefs are and then create an exact replacement of that limiting belief. So if you think you are always going to fail at something, then you need to replace that with a new truth, something that is not a limiting belief, that is telling yourself, I have the courage to continue. I have the courage to continue until I get to where I'm going. Meaning, even if you're not successful in the current moment, even if you have a failed attempt, you're simply not done yet. And you have the courage to keep going. And you're going to remind yourself of that. And you're going to tell yourself, I'm going to learn. It's never a failure as long as you choose to learn from it. I even think about the fact that I had, in my opinion, a failed marriage, right? It's a failed marriage. But in reality, I learned so much from that. I can't even tell you guys. Like I still to this day always think about things that I can learn from that and how I can apply it and make sure that I choose a better and a different path next time. I learned so much from it. So if you choose to learn, if you choose to apply it and choose to let it make your life better, instead of making you bitter, that's when there's never a failure. It's really never a failure. You're just not where you're going yet. And oftentimes when you look back with perspective, you'll say, now I get it. And I'm actually glad that previous things didn't work out because it led me to exactly where I'm at today. Number five, ditch the self-deprecating humor. Okay, raise your hand. Who has a friend that literally just rags on themselves nonstop, makes fun of themselves nonstop, always makes fun of their own faults, their own failures? And I'm not talking about like the occasional laughing at yourself. I think it is so important that everybody has a open mind and that they don't take themselves too seriously to where they can laugh at themselves, right? I think that's important, but I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the friend that is just always using self-deprecating humor as a way to like make everybody else laugh. How often have you felt so uncomfortable in those situations? Kind of like, why are you being so mean to yourself, dude? Like on one level, it can be funny maybe once or twice, but you're doing this all the time. It's all you say. Like there's no way that that feels good to yourself. So you have to ask yourself on a daily basis, how powerful are your words? How powerful are your words? The way that you can actually look at this is by looking at the constant thoughts that you have, the constant words that come out of your mouth, and how that directly correlates to how you feel and think about yourself, the actions that you take or don't take inside of your life. They directly correlate. So if you're always using this self-deprecating humor, those are the kind of actions that you're going to have inside of your life. Guaranteed, those people that have self-deprecating humor are one of the biggest self-sabotaging people in your life. Maybe that's you. Maybe you are listening to this right now and you're that person and you'd never put the two together. You never realized that your self-deprecating humor is one of the biggest reasons why you can't get out of self-sabotage. Guys, words are so incredibly powerful. Where our thoughts go and then our words go, that becomes our reality. So if you don't like your reality, if you realize that you're that person that doesn't have good self-worth or self-value, you don't believe in yourself, you don't have positive thoughts about yourself, look at the words that you speak over your life and look at your thoughts. Guarantee you those things are out of alignment and out of order. So you need to stop creating this suck fest for yourself. Jen Sincero in the book calls it a suck fest. She says ripping on yourself gets old fast, especially if it's your thing. So if you're one of those people who falls back on making fun of yourself every hour on the hour, not only are you basically begging people to think that you're a loser, but you're begging yourself to think that you're a loser. It's like hitting yourself over and over with a crowbar. Why on earth would you do that to your awesome self? Constantly making fun of yourself is such a cheap way to be funny. Anyone can do it. Push yourself to come up with a new script. Your confidence and your humor snobs will thank you. Number 6, let the love in. This is talking about being open and being receptive to love that is coming your way. Receive compliments gracefully instead of counteracting with a disclaimer such as, oh, this ratty old thing. Instead, just say thank you, period. Take care of your body too. If you're anything like me and like Jen Sincero, when you're super busy doing all of your work and you get really crazy into your schedule and even into good things and passions and projects, one of the first things that can really go by you let it go, right? You let yourself go is what I'm trying to say. Like you aren't giving as much, you know, effort into your nutrition, into your workouts, into getting your water intake in. You know, you're like, oh, I'm super busy. I'll grab a Power Crunch bar real quick, or I'll just grab an energy drink, or I'll just do this or that. And you start to let these things slide. It really affects you. And so part of letting the love in, you receive compliments and you receive love from other people, not with a deflecting manner of, oh no, you know, you're pretty too, or you don't feel like you always have to compliment someone back. Okay, let's get into this real quick. Whenever I compliment someone and they simply just say thank you, it makes me feel so good. Like as the complimenter, number one, I don't give out fake compliments. I'm a very realistic person. I'm very blunt. So like if I say something, I really mean it and I mean it with intention. And so when someone else is confident enough in themselves just to say thank you or I appreciate that, that makes me feel so good. That's like a successful compliment. But when I try to compliment somebody or I try to like speak into their lives in that way and they're like, oh no, you know, not really, or oh, I'm really not that good, or they try to just discredit it, it's like, damn, like I was trying to show you who you are. I was trying to mirror you what I see. And instead of receiving it, instead of, you know, taking that love in, you deflect it, you make it, you know, it's like not valuable, not whatever. And you're missing out on love that you could be taking in. So I want to challenge you guys next time that someone compliments you to simply smile and say thank you. And don't feel like you have to, you know, give them that compliment right back, right? It's like the girl that's like, oh my God, your outfit is so pretty. I love it. And you're like, oh, your outfit's great too. And maybe their outfit is great, but oftentimes you probably weren't going to mention their outfit, right? So don't feel like you have to do that. Instead, just look for another pocket somewhere else in the conversation where you can reflect something that you see in them or that you want to compliment them on. I think it's such a better energy exchange than always feeling like there's this expectation that you like have to immediately give back. So let the love in, receive it. And then the second part to that is to let the love into yourself and choose to prioritize yourself, because that really is the ultimate form of self-love. It is not self-love to run yourself into the ground with your work while not paying attention to your human body, the only body and vessel that you get to walk around in this earth in. And I'm completely preaching to myself in the current moment, just so we are all aware and I can be honest and upfront. The last few weeks or so, I really allowed myself to get really deep into my work because it needed to get done and, you know, had to get done. And I was traveling and all these things and there's all this pressure and commitment and things. And I allowed certain things to go by, you know, the side, like my nutrition. I definitely was guilty of not prioritizing that as much as I should have. And, you know, we make excuses. We say we're so busy. We say work and the schedule is so insane. And I was filming all day and this and that. The truth is, we make time for the things that are important for us. And more than our work, more than what we love, more than our passions, more than everything else, what we should love first is ourselves. Because if we don't have a healthy body, mind, and soul, we really aren't being as effective as we think we're being. So let the love in and love yourself. Number 7, do not compare yourself to others. Have you ever done something that you're so proud of and feel on top of the world about it until you see that someone else has done something similar that in your mind is better and all of a sudden you feel sad? Comparison is the fastest way to take all the fun out of life. It is none of your business what other people are doing. All that matters is that you're enjoying yourself and pleased with what you're creating. It's precisely your uniqueness that makes you awesome. Deciding that someone else's uniqueness is better than your own isn't exactly being your own best buddy about things. And I love how she refers to yourself as your own best buddy, right? You would never to your best friend look at their work and say, oh, I mean, that was great, but did you just see that Joe Schmo over there did it 10 times better than you? You kind of suck, right? You would never say that to them. You would appreciate them for their hard work. You would appreciate where they're at, and you would help them get better along the way. You can fully love yourself and be proud of yourself and be proud of what you're doing as you seek to get to that next level, to get a little bit better. I think every day, if we have breath inside of our lungs and a beat inside of our chest, it's up to us to live our lives fully and to chase that 1% betterment, right? I think even if all you do is get 1% healthier today, a 1% better mentality, a 1% better in your work, in your relationships, in your friendships, then that's why we're here. I don't think that we're here to be stagnant. I don't think that we're here to just maintain where we're at always. I think we're here to get every ounce of life out of life that there possibly is. And so if you're alive today, squeeze it. Squeeze life for every ounce that it is. Because life can be over so quick. And when it is over, you're not taking things with you. You don't take all these physical things with you. You don't take these accomplishments with you. It's all the unseen things in life that I think that really matter. And I think those are the things that make up just the most delicious life. Guys, life is so good and it has so much to offer and there's so much sweetness in it. And I think people miss the sweetness and the complexity and just the fullness of life by getting really focused on things that you don't get to take with you when you die. So the number 8 thing, forgive yourself. Everybody listen up. This one is extremely important. You have screwed up in the past and you will screw up again. Every human is born with the ability to make spectacular mistakes. And you're not alone. Screwing up is not your special skill, so get over it. Dragging around guilt and self-criticism is beyond unhealthy and is utterly pointless, not to mention boring. You aren't a better person for feeling guilty or bad about yourself, just a sadder one. Get clear on this. Guilt, shame, and self-criticism are some of the most destructive forces in your life, which is why forgiving yourself is one of the most powerful. Here's an excellent way to do it. Think of a specific thing that you did that you feel really bad about. Call it up in your mind and feel it in your body. Repeat the following over and over while thinking of it and really feel what you're saying to yourself. Holding on to my bad feelings about this is doing nothing but harming me and everyone else, and preventing me from enjoying my life fully. I am an awesome person. I choose to enjoy my life and I choose to let it go. Repeat this until you feel a sense of freedom and lightness around this issue. It could take a day, a week, several months, or it could happen right away. But however long it takes, do it. Because if you want to be free, you have to put in the time. And if you need to apologize to somebody, pick up the phone. I have my clients actually write out things that they need to forgive themselves or others for. Write it all out, write it down, say something similar to that, and then burn it. Might seem a little extreme, but I've had clients do this and they message me and they're like, that was one of the most powerful exercises that I've ever done. And I literally felt a lightness come over me, a peace, a sense of freedom over this thing that has troubled me and held me down for so long. So however you need to do it, find a way to forgive yourself. So these, again, are from the book You Are a Badass by Jen Sincero. So I definitely appreciate her for writing that book. I don't know her. I'm not affiliated with her. But they're just some really amazing tips and tools to love yourself a little bit more that I wanted to share with you guys. If you guys enjoy me sharing kind of, I guess it would be like just a little Spark Notes version of some of my favorite books, and you want me to continue to do that, I could add this as a part of just an episode I do here and there on the show. So definitely let me know what your feedback was about this style of episode, and I would love to hear that. So again, if this episode and this podcast has provided any value to you and your life, then I would just ask that you guys would take some time, rate and review the show on Apple iTunes. You can share it with a friend, you can text it to a friend, write it on your stories, tag me, do all the things. That's the way that the podcast grows. But thank you guys so much for joining me for today's show, and I will see you in the next one.